Hello friends, welcome to my vlog. Today I'm going to share my experience about the most asked question: how is my journey to India during this COVID times? Well, it was a little bit of uncomfortable, but we forgot everything after going to India. I traveled to India as on March 2021, hence the rules apply as per the date. We had to go to India suddenly, so we had booked an airline ticket 4 days prior, as we had to take a COVID test 72 hours before the travel, so it was important to book as per the travel date. The connecting flight to your destination must be having a transition of about 5 hours as per the new rules due to COVID testing delays. And one more thing is, we preferred going directly from Amsterdam to India instead of any other transition country in between, due to the different complications of different rules and regulations as per the country. So we traveled from Amsterdam to Mumbai in a direct flight after taking a negative PCR result report. We arrived at Mumbai airport at 11 o'clock in the night as per the local time. It was quite hectic there. The journey in the flight was fine, and especially with the kid, it's really impossible to control them, not to touch anything or sit in a place for a long time. Even after frequently sanitizing my kid, he slipped and fell on the floor and was sleeping on the sofa and just rolling everywhere. I must say, parents have to take this risk during travel. After deplaning, we have to fill up 3 forms and submit it, and then come out of the formalities, the immigration and other stuff, to outside the international department. And this is the place where we need to get a mandatory PCR test in the airport. It was extremely stressful. We had to wait in long queues. Since it was a government organization, they were taking lots of unnecessary details, and they were delaying unnecessarily and insufficient staff with unreliable systems. And also, personally, I felt the PCR test place was not so hygienic. It took about 2 hours with all these formalities. You have to also install a Arogya Setu app, which is checked there at the airport. After this, it took us almost 1 hour to get all the formalities done outside, going here and there and into the international airport. Thankfully, we did not have to wait until the results are out. Since the check-ins were not open earlier, so we had to wait 1 more hour to check in our baggage. Since it was early in the morning, my kid has slept, and we had to carry him and his luggage and walk long distance in the airport. This was the most painful part. We later utilized this car, and it was quite helpful. Coming to the food, KLM Airlines didn't provide dinner, though it was 6 p.m. Since it was too late in the night, and also the restaurants didn't have a good food, we skipped our dinner. So my friends have advised that they had food poisoning there, so we totally avoided. Therefore, as parents, I advise you to carry food for your kids. Our final destination was Hyderabad, so we took Vistara, where we have to wear a face mask and also face shield, which is provided. The person sitting in between has to wear a PPE suit. Kids are also encouraged to wear a mask. As my son was sleeping, it was quite easy. We reached Hyderabad, and since it was a domestic terminal, we didn't have any other formalities. We could go home. And after going home, we have quarantined for 10 days since we didn't want to trouble our families. This was the most unpleasant time in the trip, which we couldn't utilize. So this was my travel experience to India. In my next vlog, I would cover my experience while traveling back to Netherlands. If you have any questions, please comment or send me an email, which is placed in the description box below. Thank you for watching. Bye.